A new arrival at the California Academy of Sciences could play an important role in rescuing the world's coral reefs from climate change. They're actually baby coral that are born once a year in the Academy's cutting-edge spawning lab.
For millions of years, these colorful coral reefs have provided critical refuge for sea life all around the planet. But with ocean temperatures steadily warming from climate change, Bay Area scientists are racing now to learn how to rescue the reefs themselves.
They're just 2.5 days old at this point and just swimming around.
In a lab at the California Academy of Sciences in San Francisco, marine biologist Alora Lopez-Nandum is keeping an eye on a newborn generation of coral larvae. They're the tiny organisms that will eventually begin secreting calcium carbonate, building the skeletons that will develop into the living coral reefs that we're all familiar with. The coral spawn just once a year and normally only in the ocean, until recently.
So this was the first lab in the U.S. to be able to do this ex situ, which means in the lab with artificial lighting.
The spawning lab looks something like a darkroom and precisely mimics the light and temperatures of the habitat where the corals were originally collected in a delicate process.
The lighting in our lab is synced to the lunar cycle in Australia where our corals came from.
It was originally set in motion 4 years ago by assistant curator Rebecca Albright and her team, who then watched and waited at spawning time, not certain what would happen.
The aquarium biologist on it texted me and said, "You're not going to believe this. Everything just spawned." And so it was day 15 after the first year. Everything went crazy.
And now that excitement is giving way to a new cycle of research designed to help protect the world's threatened coral reefs from climate change. And to do that, they're quite literally testing the limits of the coral's adaptability.
The key is temperature change. The Academy team plans to expose different groups of larvae to varying degrees of warming, from normal to extreme, for about 24 hours.
And so the goal will be to see whether the corals that survived heat stress as larvae then become more heat resilient once they're coral colonies.
She says Academy researchers also plan to sequence the corals' genomes to see if specific specimens are better suited to surviving warming ocean temperatures. It's all part of a painstaking effort that launched about 4 years ago.
What we can do is ask and answer some really, really advanced scientific questions that you wouldn't be able to do elsewhere, and then translate all of that knowledge and technology to on-the-ground efforts that are proximate to coral reefs.
And perhaps help protect these fragile and essential ocean creatures.
Essential indeed. Now, the Academy is also hoping for another milestone in the future, and that would be if the spawned coral that they're growing on site matures and creates a second generation. We'll see on